Malabar. So just in case you want to be a part of it, you can go to Malabar. Malabar Hills, nahi, Malabar jo padoos ki room hai, to wahan pe jaiye. All right. Now, this session is the role of influencers in marketing is unchallenged. Please join me in inviting our celebs on the stage for a chat on the topic, the state of influencer marketing and the way ahead. Please welcome to chair the session, Ankit Wengalukar, editor at Tech2. Let's give a big round of applause. Welcome, Ankit. And to be a part of this conversation, let's welcome singer Dhwani Bhanushali. Let's give her a round of applause, Dhwani. Dhwani, what a lovely voice you are. Badi pyari si awaaz hai. Hum panel discussion se pehle hum aapki awaaz bhi sunenge. How many of you think Dhwani should sing before the panel discussion gets started? It's a part of the panel. Okay, lovely. So make sure that this panel goes on for a long time. All right. Okay, please welcome Indian author known for the Immortals of Melua. Please give it up for Amish Tripathi. Zordar taaliyan. Amish, welcome. And please welcome the man who changed music forever, the remixes ka bap. I'm a big fan of his. Please give it up for DJ Suketu. Suddenly everybody is excited ki DJ console kahan hai. And Suketu is saying, bhai, mera console kahan hai. Let's play it. All right, and Pure Bicep, please give it up for Dino James, rapper and YouTuber. Zordar taaliyan for Dino James. And Ranveer Alabadi is going to be joining us a little later. And of course, we've got another guest of ours, jo barish mein phase hue hain aur ga rahe rim jhim gire saavan. Please give a round of applause as he comes inside. 5 minute mein aa rahe hain, 5-7 minute mein aa hi jayenge. Please hamare agle guest ko bhi swagat karna. That's Rijesh Hirji, jo hamare bade acche RJ bhi hain. He's a brilliant actor. But right now, to moderate this, Ankit, over to you.
All right, we good to go? Awesome, thank you. Okay, so obviously this discussion is going to be about influencers, ya phir jise colloquially aajkal influenza log bulane lage hain, ek kisam ki bimari si ho gayi hai, and iske kya hum mareez hone wale hain ya kuch acha karne wale hain iske saath. We're going to be talking about that. Feel free to pop any questions and song requests if you guys want. Dhwani is totally going to kill me, but let's see what we can do with that. We're going to wait for, I mean, when Rajesh and Ranveer come in, we'll make them a part of the conversation as well after they do 10 push-ups each. Awesome. Dhwani, yahan pe baatein ho rahi thi barish ke gaanon ki. So I'd obviously like to start with you and asking you, what is your favorite barish ka gaana ya memory? And if you could please oblige us with like a couple of lines of that song. Thank you.
So for me, I used to go with my family to Lonavala every time it started to rain for Maggi and bhajia and chai, of course. So that's my favorite memory.
So sanskari,
Yeah, dude, yeah. I'm 21. I'm supposed to roam with my parents. We're in India.
That's amazing.
Okay. And I like this song called Iktara. So if I can sing a few lines.
Yes, please. Please, absolutely.
ओरे मनवा तू तो बावरा है तू ही जाने तू क्या सोचता है बावरे क्यों दिखाए सपने तू सोते जागते चुबर से सपने बूंद बूंद नैनों को मूंद मूंद जो बरसे सपने बूंद बूंद नैनों को बूंद बूंद कैसे मैं चलूं देख ना सकूं अनजान रास्ते गूंजा सा है कोई एक तारा 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 थैंक यू
बिग राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर धानी भानुशाली. That's amazing. Now, we have actually quite a musical bunch here. from Siketu to Dhwani to Dino. We're going to come to each one of you, but let's first start with some of the granddaddies of the business, if I may say so. Let's start with Siketu. You've literally created tunes. Joe, you know, they've set the groove for the entire country. Siketu, help us understand, you've been in the music business for how many years, how many decades now? And how is the equation in this particular industry changing, right? Because typically the biggest names in the music, in the entertainment business are traditionally, you know, jo filmon mein bade naam hote hain, ya jo playback singers hote hain. But one of the biggest disruption that happened about 5 to 8 years ago was the coming of YouTube. And this whole new breed of singers emerged from every nook and cranny, making cute videos on their webcams, from their bedrooms. And today some of these names are massive, right? Look at Jonita Gandhi, for example. Literally a YouTube product, and today she's doing so well. So talk to us about how the transformation has happened. How do you see it?
Well, I think one thing which I've observed is that when I started 20 years ago, it was just about the music and the performance, the music and the performance. There was nothing else there to support you to actually get there, other than Bombay Times. So, and that also, after that, you have to start paying for it, so wow. But yeah, that was it. But I think in the last 5, 6 years, I think it's been really fantastic, because in the last 5 years, I've come across a lot of talent which I wouldn't have come across before. When we started making remixes, if I wanted to find a Javed Ali, I had to actually go to Little Wonders, which was Kalyanji Bhai, Anandji Bhai's institute, yeah, and ask them that, you know, do you have any new singers who are actually there who will come up and who can sing something like this, because I'm making a remix. And now, I just need to get onto YouTube, I just see who's trending, what's happening, and you've got your singer right there. Wow. So it's just amazing. So I think that it's become, it's opened the market a lot, and now the best thing which I like is that collaborating with somebody, you don't have to actually go there physically to collaborate with them.
Wow.
It all happens in your studio, through the internet, through YouTube, and just sharing. It's fantastic. In fact, even three of us are working on a track together right now, and we all three are in Bombay. Akhil, Neeraj, and me. The track's going to be out soon. And we haven't gone to each other's studios at all. We're just team sharing everything and just working just like that. From Neeraj's singing to our programming, everything, just from our own studios.
Are you serious?
So it's just fantastic.
You guys, I think the way, just getting lazy, yeah, is all. And, no.
Yeah, but you just spoke about the rains and the traffic and everything like that.
Oh,
I don't
want
to spend 45 minutes going to somebody's studio.
That's,
yeah,
that's
my
nice
creativity will get slow. There's just, you know, wasted in the car just driving there.
Right. So, true.
So I think, yeah, one of the biggest changes is this: the YouTube and other platforms have just changed people getting together and music becoming more global and much better.
That's fantastic, because music really is a universal language, touches everyone. Great points you made. Key takeaway is artist discovery has been democratized, and that has become much easier. And content creation has become much easier and faster. I want to come to you, Dino.
Yeah.
Cool hat, by the way. Cool hat.
Okay, thank you so much.
And
can you hear me?
Talk to us about your content creation process. When did you start? What is it that, for the benefit of people who don't know, what is it that you do? And when did you feel like, OMG? Ye toh matlab, ye scene set ho raha hai. Like, this is happening now, bro.
This was almost 3 or 4 years back. So mine, you know, I'm a rapper. The people don't know me. I'm a rapper. I do, you know, songs on YouTube. So I've got almost 12 songs released, and I've got almost 2.1 million subscribers now. So my intention was completely pure. It was not to be a rapper. It was not to be known in YouTube. I've got a feeling I'm going through a trauma. So I did a song called Girlfriend. That was with the Culture Machine. So it just blew. So
so you went through a heartbreak, and so your release was a creative song.
Yeah, it was not a planned release that I wanted to actually do good on YouTube. This happened almost three years back, that YouTube has become very big.
Okay.
But that time people were not really aware about making videos and, you know, doing a song. Now it's comparatively a bit easier. So mine was completely very pure. I was going through a trauma, roller coaster chal raha tha dimag mein. So my intention was only that I would take a song out. After that, what was the other song? I didn't know. What was I supposed to do? I didn't know. What was YouTube? What was YouTube? I didn't know. During that song, I knew about mixing, mastering, about what is arrangement, what is music, how things should be done. I used to be a rap listener, so somehow I, you know, put all my lyrics together and rhymes together, and it just worked for me. And then the reason why I opened up my own channel was, क्योंकि मरता क्या ना करता वाली मेरी स्थिति थी यू नो सो माइन वॉज कम्प्लीटली प्योर माइन वॉज नो मार्केटिंग नो आई डिडंट वॉन्ट टू बी देयर इट वॉज प्योर ब्लेसिंग दैट एंड सेकेंड आई माई सॉन्ग वॉज सपोज टू गो इन प्यार का पंचनामा टू सो आई हैड अ डिस्कशन विद लव रंजन सो माई लिरिक्स वॉज प्रीटी लिटिल बोल्ड एंड रॉ सो दे थॉट इट्स बैड फॉर द फिल्म एंड देन आई रियलाइज आई नीड टू यू नो कम अप विद मोर सॉन्ग्स एंड देन आई नीड अ प्लेटफॉर्म टू पुट माई सॉन्ग्स इन सो इट वॉज ऑल एन एक्सीडेंट It was all an accident. So now people talk about YouTube, ki how to go on YouTube and how to create content and how to go there. And I just tell them one thing, ki, listen to your heart and do what you feel like doing right. Wow. You know, because strategies and things sometimes doesn't work. Ye dilo ka mamla hai. So, you know, whatever you do, you cannot do something to hit people. It has to be very, very pure. So, right, yeah.
Very personal. are we okay listening to a few lines of your rap here? I know it's a room full of adults.
Yeah.
It's okay with you guys, right? If you're live streaming or whatever, it's cool. No, we can hear that, right?
All
right.
So I've done a song. Actually, I've done a song called Bhokali recently. The song is basically about telling people that you know, Bhokali means it's a very North Indian word. Bhokali ka matlab hota hai self-boasting. Ki bhai ka bhokal hai. So self-boasting. So it's a song actually where I'm telling people. Ki, you know, you think that I'm very big, you think ki, when you go to colleges and events and judging shows and all, you got, you know, bodyguards and you got people are buying auto, you got all these things happening and people think that you're doing so good, you got, you know, Mercedes and you're doing, you know, doing so much of money. So I was just telling people, you know, there is a side of artists where artists are not doing all that great. You know, aapko logo ko lagta hai ki bahut main paise kama raha hu, lekin shayad main utne paise nahi kama raha hu, I'm in the process. So the track is... हर दम डराए सब थम सजाए सब इतना भरा है मेरे चेस्ट में एकदम से हाय फिर मन भराए पर कुछ भी दिखा नहीं नेक्स्ट रे कसम से भाई अवन जंप फ्रॉम हाय लगे कुछ भी नहीं है साला बस में मैं नो नू गाइज मंजिल दिखाए फिर भी रहता हूँ हमेशा डेस्परेट यूट्यूब का हाइप कमेंट और लाइक सभी लगता है मुझे एक भ्रम सा आई डोंट वांट अ लाइव मेरी सेम लाइफ फ्यूचर पर रहती है शंका करता हूँ ट्राई बट आई डोंट नो वाई वीडियोज बना रहा हूँ लेकिन चंदा यू नो ना गाइज से मेरी नॉर्मल लाइफ मिला नहीं है चांदी का चमचा दोस्त बता मैं रोज कैसे करूँ ये पोस्ट के बड़ा हूँ मैं इंस्टाग्राम में जब नोबडी नो सब भी साली सोच बेसिक चीज़ों के इंतजाम में नोच खाती सोच दो बाटली रोज पी के सोता हूँ इत्मीनान से रोज खाली टोस खा के भारी बोझ ढो के देता हूँ इम्तिहान में बहुत खाली मैंने बहुत ताली पर बहुत खाली मेरी बॉस थाली में तसोच तानी पर हम सोच सॉरी मुझे बहुत जाली लगे ग्रोथ सारी बहुत नोट कमाने किसी होप तो नहीं स्कॉच नहीं तो बेटा वोट का सही मैंने बहुत सारे मौके गवा दी फोकट में लगती सारी भोग काली
Wow.
It's called Go Gallery, yeah. Thank you.
आपने basically ये 45 मिनट का जो पैनल डिस्कशन है ये एक गाने में उतार दिया इन्फ्लुएंजा बीमारी के बारे में बिल्कुल सही आपने
कहा yeah, thank
That's you. amazing. Good stuff, man. Good stuff.
So I want to actually, you know, portray things.
3 years, 2 million subscribers, completely organic. That's pretty remarkable.
Yeah, like I said, you know, because sometimes कुछ चीजें पता ना होना बहुत बड़ी ब्लेसिंग होती है मार्केटिंग पता ना होना बहुत बड़ी ब्लेसिंग होती है देन यू मोर फोकस ऑन योर वर्क यू नो सो मैं को बोलते हैं कि भाई ये जा रहा है आई ओपन अप I sometimes struggle to log out.
अच्छा
कि मुझे पता नहीं रहता कैसे लॉग आउट करना है सो आई कैन पुट कम्प्लीटली दैट्स वेरी सबकॉन्शियस सो यू इवेंचुअली पुट कम्प्लीटली योर एनर्जी टू योर प्रोडक्ट सो नो सो आई डोंट नो
गुड स्टफ गुड स्टफ लवली सो फ्रॉम वन म्यूजिकल टैलेंट एंड रैपर ऑन यूट्यूब टू अनदर वन अमीश मैं आपको एंड में आई एम गोना कम टू यू बिकॉज जितना भंडार मेरे ख्याल से मार्केटिंग का एंड इस सब का आपके पास है इट्स ओनली फेयर दैट आई कम टू यू लास्ट So Dhwani, to you, congratulations on just getting graduated.
Thank you.
Like, wow, what? That's amazing. And congratulations on the song Coca, which came out this morning and is already totally legit viral on the World Wide Web. It's breaking the internet.
Thank you so much. It's Varun Badshah.
Have you guys seen Coca? Aaj subah hai, Sonakshi, Badshah and
It's a remake.
Dhwani.
Again.
Coca. Yeah, it's a remake.
I'm so sorry. That's,
Well, it's okay. So, talk to us about your journey. Your song Vaaste garnered the fastest 200 million views on YouTube ever on the T-Series YouTube channel. Isn't it all too surreal? Did you see this coming and how are you dealing with that?
I didn't see any of this coming. We were just focusing on how to make a good product, you know, for people, how to make a good story for them to see. So it just happened the time we put it on and the next morning I was like, dude, it's hitting millions. And I'm like, wow. And my dad is like, I'm proud of you. And
I'm proud of you. Let's go to Lanavla.
Done. Okay, so that happened, and before that, Leja came in, and even Leja was doing well. So I think it's not me, it's the whole team. And of course, when you put out good content on, you know, the social media or on YouTube, people tend to get attracted to it, and they watch it over and over again. So yeah, I think that's what we did.
I love the humility where you said it's not just me, it's the entire team. I guess if you keep that attitude and you keep your head down and keep working, success will never really be far away from you. So that's fantastic. Is it difficult? Is there a pressure? Because aapke pichle kuch gaane hundreds of millions kar chuke hain. Jab koi naya piece of content aap leke aate hain, is there a pressure that uttri, this should do well. I hope it does well. And then does one use any and every kind of mechanism to make sure it is again doing those kind of numbers? Kya aapki puri zindagi aur creative process numbers se dominate or dictate hoti hai?
Not really. I mean, I don't really think about the numbers, because if you're working well, if you're doing like a good thing, if you're making good music, I don't think you should be worried about numbers. If you're making a good video, I don't think numbers will come. Because here people want to see a good video, a good they want to hear good music. So that's what I do. I mean, all of us, we strive to make good music, make a good song, make a even better video than the last time, which is relating to the song and tells a story. Then the numbers will come. I don't really think about
the
numbers.
Okay, interesting. As a YouTuber, I mean, talk to us about your social media mix. Thali pe kya kya hai? Where all do you create what all kind of content? And have you started engaging with brands to do branded content and things like that? You have a house announcement?
Sorry to butt in. It's incredible. What a story. We love your music and you're doing well. And you actually give us food for thought. And we love sare dukhyare dil aapki awaaz ko sunke kehte hain, hai zindagi kitni khoobsurat hai. But thank you, Amit. That's been incredible. Rajesh has come in. And let's give a big round of applause for the man who actually puts a lot of smile. And Rajesh Hirji. Sir, kahan phas gaye the? Sare panel discussion ko aapne latka ke rakhi. Rajesh, thank you very much. Kahan phas gaye?
I apologize profusely for the delay. I had to swim here, so.
Oh,
you're pretty. If, you know, main maan lunga ki koi influencer hai, if they can convince the BMC ke Mumbai mein pehle din ki barsaat mein andheri subway band nahi karte, bhai saab, Gokhale bridge yun hi gir jayega. Sorry, man. Really sorry, guys. Please.
Humne kaha tha ki aap se 10 push-up karwayenge jab aap aayenge.
Pagla gaye ho kya?
Nahin. Okay, I'll let you settle down.
Yes, yeah,
grab
absolutely.
Some water. Back to you, Dhwani. You were. What's your social media mix like? Have you started doing branded content and things like that?
I recently did the Gulf Oil video for Team Pride for the cricket season.
Okay.
It's just started. I started with that. I think there are more brand integrations to come forward.
Okay.
And all I do is make videos and sing. There's
okay.
Nothing more than that. I would love to get into branding and stuff, but it's just started. I'm just 2 videos old, and I think
so. It's
there's
easier
a lot
for you
ahead.
Because you're within your character itself. आपको कुछ अलग से नहीं करना है. कोई डांस नहीं करना है, कोई किसी को टैग नहीं करना है, कोई सिट अप पुश अप नहीं करने हैं.
No, 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 no. I want to be a pop star, so I want to stick to my music and the brands that I associate with, and I should believe in them before associating with them.
Well, you want to be a pop star, that with that comes the territory of doing everything, right?
Yeah.
From like, I don't know, Kenny Gutka to like everything, sab kuch aa jata hai usme. Would you
but
do?
But why Kenny Gutka? What I don't do Kenny Gutka, so I'm not going to associate with
Kenny. I was
just
going to ask, if there are brands or products that go beyond what you personally don't use, for example, but it's...
But that depends, I think that depends on the influencer. I think they have to be
true. I'm asking about you.
Yeah, but me, I am like that. I will not do something that I don't use personally.
Okay.
Because I can't go ahead and tell people that I'm using a fairness cream to, you know, get this skin tone.
It'd be scary if you needed a fairness cream, actually.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So this comes with the genes. It comes with, because my parents are fair, I'm fair. It's not that I used some fairness cream and I got it. So I'm never going to stand for something like this.
Okay. Interesting. Okay. Amish, you have a brand new book coming out. It's called Ravan and the End of Aryavart or some.
The End of Aryavart?
No.
Ravan, the Enemy of Aryavart.
The Enemy.
Yeah.
Jai Aryavart. Yeah, absolutely. So, the thing that strikes me most about you, Amish, is apart from the fact, if people don't know, that he's India's most remarkable writing talent, is how innovatively and ingeniously you use marketing tools as an author. And a lot of these ideas actually pop up from the same head that's coming up with these amazing mythological sagas and stories. So talk to us about some of the innovative things you have done in a way, use your influence to market your book and your titles.
Ravan, Enemy of Aryavarta is launching on 1st July. And how it works for me, at least I believe, artists should be, for the want of a better term, a little schizophrenic. Okay, so when you're actually in your creative process, when you're writing, when you're creating music or anything, you should frankly be cut off from everyone. I tend to be that way. During my writing phase, and you won't find me at parties, I don't do TV panel discussions. I'm not very social in any case. So I just...
I'm glad you don't do TV panel discussions, yeah?
Yeah, thank you.
It's a lifesaver.
So I only read and write in that phase, and I don't really interact with too many people. And when I'm writing, I only think of the book. I care a damn about how people will react to it, how readers will react to it, how critics or publishers or even my editor, how they'll react. Because the moment you start doing that, you corrupt the process. Okay, so the creative process has to be completely pure. It should be driven only by your emotions and by your heart. The thing is that when the book is ready, or when the music is ready, or anything, when the product is ready, then you have to become a practical, pragmatic marketing guy. You know, I see it...
Do you know, you got to pay attention to that.
No. It's work for him, man. I'm telling you where I'm coming from. Because the publishers invested tons of money in my books. For me to take a stand that, dude, I have to be pure and you make losses, that's your problem. My man, that's adharma, yeah. That's wrong. You know, it's my duty to make sure he does not lose money, which means I have to do every damn thing that I can do without change. The product cannot be touched. The book cannot be changed. I'm not going to change anything in the book to make it appeal to some segment or someone. The book has to be pure.
Right.
It cannot be touched. But how does one market this so that it sells?
Right.
And the publisher actually makes money, or retailers, agencies, whoever is associated with my book,
they
should not lose money. They should benefit.
Right.
So
you've done something very innovative for the current book. Why don't you tell us about that?
Okay. So then the ideas, then, you know, I can't take, claim credit for all the ideas. Most of the ideas come. I have a fantastic team, actually.
That's amazing.
The only credit I can take claim for is that I have the ability to pick a good idea.
Sure.
Okay. And drive with it. So one of the things that we did for Ravan, I always think a marketing strategy has to, we have a room full of marketers out here. Often we tend to take off on our own, you know, and marketers. And we just want to do something innovative for the heck of being innovative.
Right.
Right. Just because we want to win some award or some other nonsense like that. Marketing has to tie into the overall business strategy.
Right.
Right. So what we've done for Ravan, because the media scenario has changed. You know, the Sermon from the Mounts and you bringing out ads and everyone will follow it. That could have been done maybe 4 or 5 years ago.
Correct.
It started changing slowly. Last 2 years, it's changed very rapidly.
Right.
All right. The audio, it's not a one-way communication. Now it's a dialogue.
It's a dialogue.
The audience also, as Sugedu said very rightly, is democratized.
Yeah.
The internet has truly democratized the conversation. So they communicate back to you as well. So you are not in complete control of your brand. You can only just trigger a conversation and hope for them to talk about you. Okay, because some brand taking out an ad, that has lower and lower effectiveness
right.
going forward.
Right.
So how can one do something which actually is linked to the book, linked to the product you want to market, but also works for the users so that they may want to spread it, share it with their friends.
Right.
So we did something innovative. From what I've been told, it's never been done before for a book in India, which is a filter. You know, so...
Everyone knows face filters, right? Where you become
Facebook
a kutta billi and like rabbit and all that on Snapchat. So yeah,
you know what it's like. So
Funny. Face filters.
Oh,
it's your jam, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm 44. I got to know of
You're
this.
You're 44.
Only, I got to know of this only 3 weeks back. Okay.
Oh my God.
I'm a tech cretin. So I have, you know, my agency actually makes training videos for me.
Oh.
How do I make an Instagram story? I'm not joking. Okay.
Are you
serious? I have no freaking clue. Okay. So they made training videos for me. Ki dekho ye button dabao, fir ye karo. Okay. So anyway, so we discovered this, and the idea that emerged was we have a kick-ass cover for
right.
Ravan Enemy of Aryavarta. The agency did a lovely job.
Mm-hmm.
Can we kind of, you know, have something which works with the cover and insert my readers into it?
Okay.
Okay. So that they, you know, because the person that most of us love most is usually ourselves.
Correct.
Right?
We're all megalomaniacs.
We are all. Yeah. I mean, it is a narcissistic world, right? So if you're going to, if you want someone to share something, if you can insert them into the conversation,
right.
They'd certainly share it.
So it's a filter on Facebook.
What it does, you put a camera on, your face comes on, and Ravan's headgear and, you know, mustache and the cover and the beard, everything comes on.
You look okay. quite dapper
with
in
the,
that mustache.
With the music.
And the,
I look better with the Ravan headgear.
Yeah, I think so.
I agree.
It's an inner demon in
and
you.
It comes, the inner demon, yeah. So it comes in with the music and, you know, the background, the cover in
effects,
the background.
Yeah.
And this comes as a filter. And you can record a video and post it on Instagram. I still haven't figured out how they do it, but somehow you can post it on Instagram, I think, story, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah.
Yeah.
Instagram story automatically.
This is so cute.
And on Facebook automatically.
Wow.
Okay.
Okay.
And you can kind of click a button, and one is just you as Ravan. If you click a button, then the cover comes on, and Ravan is there in all his muscular glory,
right.
But your face is on there, okay?
Works,
so you're
works
on the
for
cover.
Me. I think with my dad board, I would love that, you know?
Yeah, you'd love
just
a Ravan
the face
board.
And the six-pack
yeah,
abs Ravan of
Ravan. Is, Ravan is like a killer.
Hunk. You know, so. That's amazing.
Yeah, he's huge. So,
very cool idea.
So and then it comes with the music. You can share the video, you can share the picture. And we just launched it this morning. We already have, you know, it's going on my page. We launched it with another partner, TVF.
Okay.
So let's see how this works. Now, there's something different. One of the things I've learned is not about the amount of money you're investing, usually.
Mm-hmm.
And usually, if you have bigger budgets, you stop thinking. So you don't use a creative idea. You
right.
just try and just randomly throw money at it.
Sure.
Often, creative ideas work better.
That's amazing. That's a very cool one. I can't wait to try it out. Let's come to you, Vrijesh. All right. I think aapne jitni baar apne aapko I guess, reinvent kiya hai in your creative career. You've been a content creator most of your life, from radio to theater to movies to writing to, God knows, television, obviously. And
I've also written copy before I started acting.
Wow.
So.
And that. How is, according to you, how is the entertainment landscape changing now and today when anybody and everybody can become a so-called star or a celebrity? Just, you know, I'm sure you've heard of the crying boy of TikTok, right?
There is a page on Facebook called Boys Who Cry Passionately on TikTok.
Yeah, Boys Who Cry
Passionately. It's the shit, man. You have to see it. Huh?
It's ridiculous, especially if you're like at home and it's raining a lot out there. Just like sit and watch these young boys cry passionately. So, entertainment landscape puri tarah se change ho gaya hai. Just the way music landscape has changed completely. How do you, as an industry veteran, how do you view this change? Is it good? Is it bad? Is it positive? Is it negative? How do you process this?
Okay, so thanks for calling me a veteran. But I'm in the same age group as Amish is. Also, I need to do the Ravan thing tomorrow because I have you on my breakfast show tomorrow morning. For the book, yeah. I'm also going to click a selfie. That's what the influencers do, selfie.
Yeah. Hey, I'm here just for the Instagram followers. That's
superb, there
that's
you
it.
Are.
Bus.
No, so I was at the airport. I was traveling to Hyderabad or someplace and I was at the Crossword bookstore and I was asking the guy for a book and I see this man standing next to me. Now I see the bookstore guy reaching for his phone and looking at me with dastardly intent. Okay, and I say, ek minute. And this man next to me, I click a photo with him. I say, sir, may I please bother you for a selfie? And he says, oh man, okay. And I click the selfie with him. He leaves and the guy who's going to click the selfie with me, the crossword guy, looks at me and says, kon tha wo? Wo Brian Lara tha mere bhai. तो उसको गोलमाल के सांप के साथ पहले सेल्फी खींचनी है ब्रायन लारा के साथ बाद में सो यस या आई मीन सो क्रिकेट इज एंटरटेनमेंट इट्स द ज़ेनिथ ऑफ एंटरटेनमेंट ऑफ कोर्स द स्नेक फ्रॉम गोलमाल इज आल्सो वेरी हिसी बट यू नो एट मेनी लेवल्स एंटरटेनमेंट हैज बीन डम डाउन
वाओ यू से यू थिंक दैट
एब्सोल्युटली You think boys who cry, meri mehbooba, that's serious dumbing down of entertainment. But people love it. So theater has this whole big thing. It's like, for example, Nasir Bhai would say, don't play to the gallery. No, Nasir Bhai, it is all about playing to the gallery at this point, especially when you're called an influencer on social media.
Right.
If Divya, I don't know if you managed to get that photo, okay. So there is a lady called Natalie Shatler or something, okay? And she, her bio says influencer, DM for collabs on Instagram, etc. And she just put out a photo of herself standing by a paddy field in Vietnam with her back to the camera. And she says, oh my God, you know, I'm wondering what I have that these poor farmers don't. And she's in a bikini. She's in a bikini. So I'm saying becoming, and that is also entertainment, yeah? So the whole concept of entertainment has changed. How, like I said, it's been dumbed down. It's become extremely simplistic. You know, and maybe to entertain, all you need is serious guts, extremely pliable tear ducts, as boys who cry on TikTok prove, a phenomenal workout routine, and you know, I'm not being sexist here, but 82 shades of lipstick.
Oh God.
So it's the whole, it's changed, yeah. It's entirely changed.
I want to quickly come to you, Dino, for a reaction to what Rajesh said. I saw you looking at him intently because you are literally a part of this new wave of content creators. Dino James, Rajesh is an amazing rapper. Inka jo gana girlfriend tha wo kafi viral hua tha, and he runs a fantastic YouTube channel.
Sare gaane waise maine kiye.
Bilkul. Nahin, but heartbreak ki baat hi kuch aur hoti hai, mere bhai. So what do you think, or how would you react to what he said about content dumbed down ho raha hai, kuch bhi ho raha hai, and sab kuch viral ho raha hai, and things like that?
Just one sec. I just want to say one thing. I'm saying that when you're speaking of Dino here, or when you're speaking of the lady there, that is not part of that.
No, sure.
They have something really to show for it.
Sure, absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's very temporary. I think it's very, very temporary.
What is temporary?
What about the stars and Instagram and temporary stars that you're talking about from Instagram or TikTok and all? I think it's a wave, jo instant thodi der ke liye aata hai, aapko entertain karta hai. Jaise ki wo, I'm not saying it's good or bad. Like that girl who jisne aankh mari thi and it was all over in India, and suddenly her followers gone from zero to.
That was actually part of a movie.
Whatever. Yeah, so yeah. Basically, you know, this is not talent
Hello
showcase.
Friends, chai pilo.
That. Yeah, all that thing, yeah. Whatever you're talking about. I think these are very temporary. This can't be actually, you know, like inka jo talent hai, hum zamanon se dekhte hue aa rahe.
Correct.
Aur wo talent.
correct.
aur wo talent hai, talent. To mujhe lagta hai ki wo ek entertainment ka part zarur hai, jisse aapko bahut manoranjan aata hai, aap forward karte hai, aap dekhte hai, whatever reason se. But that can't be an entertainment for a longer time.
Okay.
So it's a wave. So I've got nothing against it because you can't stop it. This is what it is nowadays. Okay. And it's getting bigger also because people loving it.
Correct. Okay.
You know, so you deny it or you love it. That is what it is.
Sure.
So, but as a talent, so you have to figure out what you can do not to get influenced with all these things. So I think I don't hate them. I don't love them. But ye chal raha, you can't
to
stop
each,
it.
To each their own. So Getu, I want to come to you. We were having this conversation earlier. Of course, as content creators, you may like them, not like them. Wo to completely subjective matter hai. Baat wahan badal jati hai. Conversation pura naya rukh le leta hai jab paise ki baat aati hai. When brands are parking money behind these content creators, so-called content creators, or just, you know, trash makers or whatever it is, and then they start lending their voice or their network to anything and everything, right? I remember you said this, you gave this beautiful analogy about the knife. Is this making the environment or the marketing environment or social media a murkier, cloudier, dirtier place? Because you may not really know the ethics or the morality of the content creator and what they stand for, and everything goes.
Just to let you know what he was talking about, the knife, and he asked me about what do I think about influencers. I think influencers are like a knife. You can use a knife to cut vegetables, eat good food and be healthy, or you can use it to kill somebody. So it's just that sometimes because of the influencers, and if you get one of the wrong ones, you probably just land up, you know, paying the person for doing very bad work for you and promoting your work in a bad way. So I think if you identify your influencer properly, money is going to get involved everywhere you like it or not. It's like, it's the thing. When I thought I wanted to get into music and DJing, I thought that, oh, it'll be just fun, you know, going out to nightclubs and partying. And then when I started seeing the money, I'm like, oh, yeah, money. So it is going to happen. So there are going to be genuine influencers who will probably change their motto for the money. And you have to just be careful to identify that line that, you know, somebody might be doing good work for you. An influencer might really affect your product in a positive way. But if that influencer starts doing anything and everything, you as a brand or as a product should know to pull back from that influencer and go to somebody else. So yes, money is a big part of it, but I think you cannot disregard them for sure.
Right.
I mean, they are influencers because what they say or they do, people believe them.
Right.
And you need them right now to be with you for your product or your brand. But I think it's just identifying the right one, that's
it. Amish, do you think we are actually already seeing the wave turn of going with these influencers jinke millions of followers hote hain, Chaddi Banyan se leke, Five Star Hotel se leke, sabhi cheez ko endorse karte hain. And brands are increasingly getting exhausted and tired with it and are actually going to micro-influencers jinke bhale hi 4 se 10,000 subscribers ya followers hon. But the engagements and conversations they're having with their followers are extremely meaningful and very deep. Do you think we are already seeing that wave turn towards micro-influencers? And the more learned and evolved brands ideally prefer that route rather than just, you know, numbers kitne hai, reach kitna hai, impressions kitne hai.
Look, clearly...
I'm asking you this specifically so people know because you've been a banker and a marketer. So, I mean, you know, there's that lens as well on
look,
you.
The way I see it, marketing is not just about getting viewerships on your video. That means nothing. At the end of the day, it has to convert into sales. What building on what Suketu had said earlier, that the entire conversation has been democratized because of the internet, right? The internet has actually...
But has it really? Has it really?
Let me complete my point.
Let me complete my point.
Democratization did not turn out the way we thought it would be, okay? One of the interesting things you've seen across all types of products, including in books, it's like the hollowing out of the middle, right? Earlier, even the average guy would get average sales, right? So, it's a very interesting play out of Aristotle's hollowing out of the middle. The middle are losing ground completely. Either someone gets everything or you only have the tail end, right? So, like I can tell you in books, for example, the average bestseller would sell 10, 15, 20,000. Now you either have very few numbers selling millions or people selling absolutely nothing, okay? Because on the internet, on your phone, on apps, it's not easy to browse, right? You go looking for something that you heard of from your friends. And your friends will either hear completely niche things or people right at the top. From what I've heard, this is playing out not just in books, it's playing out in various other areas as well. So which means that brands have to be aware of this, okay? The second thing that happens, democratization, the way I think it's playing out is that the one-way conversation is gone, right? It's a two-way conversation, which means whether you're a whatever quote-unquote influencer, I mean, I don't know what that word is supposed to imply. Influencer or a brand, whatever, if it's a two-way conversation, you have to keep it real, okay? Pretending to be something you're not is a load of bullshit, is going to get you into trouble. If you are on social media every day and you are actually not a well-read person, but you're pretending to me, dude, I'm extremely well-read, it'll come out, okay? Anyway, in anything that you do, or like if I pretend to be tech-savvy, okay, I'm not, I have no clue, all right? I try my best to learn. So I should keep it real. I shouldn't pretend to be tech-savvy when I'm not. You should be who you are. Some people will like you. Some people will not like you. That's cool.
Tomorrow, if a big smartphone brand comes and says, hey, Amish, hamara naya phone aa raha hai. Please phone lijiye hamara. 30-second video banaiye, Instagram pe daliye. Here's millions of rupees.
If the pitch is so simple, if the pitch is that the phone is so well designed and intuitive that even an Amish can understand it. Yeah, okay. Okay. But the only brands, like for example, that I've endorsed are something like a Kindle, which I use. I'm an obsessive reader. All right. So, but there are many brands that I refuse to endorse. And there is a real thing of money, man. I'm lucky my books earn enough money, so I don't have to do all this. It's very easy to stand on a high horse and say, nahi, everyone has to keep it real. There's a real thing of paying the bills at the end of the month also. One doesn't, you know, deny that pressure. But most influencers have to realize, you keep it real, you cannot keep up an act for too long in the modern world. Just be who you are.
Right.
And realize some will like you, some will not. That's cool, boss. That's the way the world is.
That's amazing. Okay. I want to start with Brijesh and take this question to each and every one of you. Name one thing that you saw any of your... Yes. That was for Brijesh. So name one thing that you guys saw on any of the...
If he does 10 sit-ups, do we get 5 minutes more or...
Are you sure?
Amish, you should hear the interview now tomorrow.
I'll start with push-ups.
Ravana, enemy of Aryat, I'll cut out enemy only. Ravana of Aryat.
Okay. कोई एक ऐसी चीज जो आपने किसी influencer को देखते हुए की या उसके बारे में बात करते हुए देखा, and then you actually ended up, you know, using or going and buying and seeking out that product or service or something like that.
I don't know about a product or service, but something that I didn't buy, but that I thought about very, very deeply. So there is an influencer on Twitter called Anak Desai. He's been a marketer, he's been a brand person, etc. Anak has also been a friend. Now, Anak at one point was in a conversation about getting out of your comfort zone. And when I was offered this to host the breakfast show at Big FM, now in my head, I'm saying to myself that you know, I'm an actor. How am I going to do this? B, I have to wake up at 5:30 every morning, which is ridiculous. Yeah. My son is also, well, almost 3 months old now, and he keeps me up a large part of the night. I got into a conversation with Anak about this.
Okay.
And I did realize that one of the major things that I was thinking about was, am I okay getting out of my comfort zone, which is going to a film set, working for about 12 minutes through the day, and the rest of it, you know, calling in for pizza and just having a blast. But I did. And I'm immensely enjoying myself.
Yeah.
So that is something I did off a conversation that I was with, you know. So I do not off the top of my head remember if I bought anything.
No, that counts. That counts. By the way, I've done that too. 1 year of breakfast show at Big FM.
Oh, fantastic.
Back in 2012. Yeah.
We need to talk.
Crazy. 5 in the morning. Ridiculous. Dino, anything that you saw?
No,
or...
I haven't actually bought anything from an influencer. No, nothing actually. Nothing that I could remember.
Okay. You don't follow any street fashion bloggers?
No.
Your style could totally go as hashtag OOTD, man.
Yeah, I sab jugaad karke jaisa hua samne wo lekar aa gaya. It was raining, so I was just wondering actually what to wear. So whatever, yeah. Nothing
okay,
that I can
okay. remember. Okay. Amish?
Firstly, what does hashtag OOTD mean?
Hashtag outfit of the day.
Ah.
Oh. Bro!
How the hell am I supposed
bro,
to? I'm 44,
yeah,
man.
Bust ya.
Okay. No, I don't think I've ever bought anything based on what an influencer says. No, I mean,
nahin?
I'm not very brand conscious, so I just buy what appeals to me.
I'm probably asking the question to the wrong demographic. Dhwani, I'm sure you have like 10 things that you've like seen, spotted.
No, I don't really follow influencers that much. But, you know, my skin was breaking out in the middle, so I saw these few Harper Bazaar videos wherein, you know, these actresses do those, my sleep routine and stuff. So then I went and I bought those products and they actually worked, so.
So then we're going to see your sleep routine video soon?
Yeah, you have to ask Harper Bazaar to contact me first.
Why do fans and followers say that? Show us how you get ready to go to bed.
How
is that?
It's quite interesting, but.
Homo sapiens, the smartest species on the planet. Show us how you get ready to go to bed.
And yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Suketu. Amish is like, ye is grah pe ho raha hai. Ye kalpanik dunya nahi hai. Bilkul. Amish, yes. So yeah, bro, yes.
I'm not really following any influencer per se, but I don't know if Dan Bilzerian is a influencer
oh
or not
my
per se.
God.
So
how many people here know Dan Bilzerian?
So
of course, all the men know Dan Bilzerian.
So the thing is that I follow him, and I used to really hate this DJ, Steve Aoki. I never liked his music, his performance, or anything. And then I suddenly started following Dan Bilzerian, and he's with him all the time. So
yeah.
I said, if this guy is following him and partying with him and going for his concert, kuch to hoga. So I actually started listening to Steve Aoki's music a little bit more intently.
And it's...
Just to know that, why is this guy, you know, promoting this guy, so promoting Steve Aoki. So not a product
yeah.
per se, but yeah, at least I started listening to an artist which I'd never liked before.
Wow.
Just because of this. So yeah, I would say that I do get influenced by certain people.
Dan Bilzerian ka kisi ke life pe kuch positive impact hua, ye sunke matlab rona aa raha hai mujhe. Dan Bilzerian is the most obnoxious playboy millionaire in the world on Instagram, just so you guys know who we are talking about. Huh? Are you kidding me? Of course I am. Of course I am. All right, let's actually go to the audience and try and see if you guys have any questions. If you want any of these people to follow you on Instagram, you can just like shout that out as well. But totally up to you guys. Kuch puchna hai to. Seriously, sab so gaye kya? I know we are like the post-lunch session, but nothing? Absolutely nothing to... Okay, I'm going to do a round of who, according to you guys, apart from yourself, one quick reco of who do you all think people in the room should follow on whichever social media, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, Facebook, kuch bhi ho sakta hai, TikTok. Just say, inka kuch bhala hoga, not Dan Bilzerian, Suketu. Or Dan Bilzerian, usse bhi bhala ho sakta hai, whatever. Quickly, let's start with you, Brajesh. Haan, yala. Hamara neta Brajesh Hirji. अरे यार वो तो है अच्छा अच्छा at least okay take the mic and at least
we will recommend just each of us collectively
amazing
that's five people
that's exactly how a political system
works. This is called union bazi
that's how Indian parliament works as well okay just shout out your social media that you'd like people to follow
Brajesh I think it's an underscore Hirji
I think it's an, okay
but it's Brajesh Hirji you'll find it
okay on Instagram
but also no so for example I tell you something very strange that happened with me since you were asking about you know an influencer that I've seen hawking something and have I bought it or not so there is a friend of mine who is an influencer a television actress who I follow on Insta and she was pushing this this hotel somewhere in Mahabaleshwar or whatever which she had gone to and I didn't land up going there I went to a hotel which competes with them and I was very happy so yeah just saying that happens too
okay Brajesh Hirji on Instagram
yeah it's D-I-N-O-J-M-S
perfect D-I-N-O-J-M-S
yeah
perfect
mine simple @ author Amish A-M-I-S-H yeah. On Duane. Twitter Instagram Facebook everywhere
superb
Duane. I'm not on TikTok no
so disappointing I want to see crying videos of you Amish
hang on I should clarify that I've been told my agency has created an account for me on TikTok. I haven't used it.
Oh my God.
I don't intend to.
Dhwani?
Me, Instagram is Dhwani Bhanushali 22.
Why are you so shy about it?
Because I'm literally asking them to follow me.
But why 22?
I am 21, but my birthday is 22nd March.
Are you sure? Okay, too good. Fantastic. Suketu? What's Instagram?
Well, huh? My Instagram handle is DJ Suketu, Twitter is DJ Suketu, Facebook is DJ Suketu, but I think you guys should follow Dan Bilzerian, seriously.
And I am Gadgetwala on Instagram, in case you guys, most of you all just write to me saying, sir, 10,000 rupees mein kaun sa phone kharidu? That's my life. I go on a date, 10,000 rupees mein kaun sa phone kharidu? I'm like, kidding me. Anyway, thank you so much for being such a lovely audience, and thank you so much to the panelists, Suketu, Dhwani, Amish, Dino and Rajesh. Thanks
what
so
a fantastic panel discussion. Thank you, Ankit. You really put life into this. You know, for our photographers, I want you to just move inside. And a photographer, kab se bol rahe ki boss, andar wali chair pe bithana Ankit ko. And please do follow Rajesh ka kal ka show. Rajesh has so much of saamp ka poison tomorrow morning, so he's going to give it back to Anish. So, oh boy, this is incredible. What a session this is. Really lighting up. Real. Thank you very much for this. And thank you, Anish. Anish ka ek show bhi aa raha hai Instagram ke how to use Instagram in a different way. Sorry, right, Anish? Oh boy, this is incredible. All right, we've got a token of appreciation. May I request Vice President Brand and Communications, Inox Leisure Limited. Let's welcome Shalini Gupta on the stage to give a token of appreciation to our fantastic panel. Ladies and gentlemen, token of appreciation for a very, very special panel. Guys, अच्छा दो मिनट के लिए खेद है, because यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा social media, we all social media influencers, so we need to do that. Yeah, hang on. All right, this is a really nice one. All right, guys, Dhwani, you need to be on the stage. We've got a token of appreciation. Thank you, Suketu. Brilliant. Dino, Anish, we want you to be on the stage. One sec, please. Oh, boy. This is brilliant.